For woodworking joinery, screws are easy, dowels look nicer, but which one is stronger?
I'm going to test these by measuring how much force it takes to pull them straight apart, and actually made a lot of test samples with different types of dowels and such, and these are all very small to fit in my test apparatus. So I made these metal brackets for my pull test apparatus, and the test pieces just slide right into those.
First one is a 3/8-inch dowel glued with regular yellow carpenter's glue. And that failed at 219 kilograms. Dowel didn't pull out of this, but did pull slightly out of this part here. Next test piece held together by a number 8 screw. I can see this is starting to open up, but it hasn't failed yet. Okay, still holding, but that gap is not very nice looking. So looking at this, it appears that the screw head is just sinking into this piece of wood. The screw is still holding in this part here, even though it's screwed into end grain. Well, and it finally failed just splitting apart. Now this screw head is kind of a wedge that helps to split the wood apart. A drywall screw's got a much flatter head. So let's try that next. So at 100, it really hasn't opened up very much yet. And this is as much as the other one held. Now we are opening up here now. And by the looks of it, we're also pulling the head through the piece of wood. And the force is now actually quite a bit less. Force has gone up. I guess it just depends on how hard the grain is that I'm pulling through at any one moment, because that force keeps going up and down.
200. But not much use with it opened up this far. And I think with that bang, the thread let go of this piece here. So that head got way sunk in, but not as far as the head went in on this one, which probably went to about here before it split the wood in half. Whereas the dowel had the higher force, and it didn't really pop apart until it got very close to the maximum force. So that joint stayed good for the longest. But with the head sinking in being such a problem, I'm wondering about pocket hole screws where the head is on end grain, so maybe this will do a little bit better. So at 100 kilograms, we're already quite opened up, so that would be pretty ugly for furniture. Oh, and now the force is dropping off, so I think what's happening is the screw's yielding out of this bottom piece here. And I made this so that the screw penetrated almost all the way through the piece of wood to give it maximum engagement here. But still, it started to pull out, and you can see this piece is starting to crack here, so definitely pulling out of the bottom part here.
So, dowel joint wins then, right? Well, I got a lot more pieces to test still.
3/8-inch dowel joined with tight bond 3. Oh, rats. My clamping thing broke here. All right, second tight bond 3 sample, same test. Oh no, same problem. Now this next one is dowel joint of sorts with just a little piece of bamboo skewer. And that failed with a dowel starting to pull through the bottom piece here at 126 kilograms, which is still more than the pocket hole pieces.
I made 32 test specimens in all. Here's a few more. This one's joined with a 5mm skewer. This one's a 3/8-inch fluted dowel pin. And a 5/16-inch fluted dowel pin. And a 1/4-inch fluted dowel pin. Now with all my dowel joined ones, of course, there's always glue squeeze out, and that makes for a butt joint with the rest of the wood. So I rubbed a little bit of salad bowl finish on the piece of wood to make sure the glue wouldn't actually stick to the flat surface.
I broke all my test specimens now. Let's look at the results.
The 3/8-inch dowel is clearly stronger than all the screws, especially the pocket hole ones. But for the 3/8-inch dowel, I had a lot of them where it actually failed where the wood was clamped. So I have a little yellow thing at the end of those lines because I don't know how long those lines actually would be. But then I had the idea of reclamping those pieces using a different metal bracket that I made and pulling on them again. And on retesting, none of those 7 samples failed where I was grabbing it, so my other gripper for those samples was probably less than ideal.
And here's my results, numbers, and the graph.
The dotted area here, those are the retests. So I just used the retest here, but I marked it separately in the graph to show which ones I had to test twice. Weakest was the pocket holes, and that's because there's only so much thread that goes into the wood here, and that just failed by yielding out of here. Next was the number 8 wood screw, and that tended to fail by the head just pulling into the soft wood, whereas the drywall screw, that's these ones here, did better because that head is harder to pull in. But most of these screws, even before they failed, there was a gap that opened up. So at 80 kilograms, we could see the number 8 wood screws and the pocket holes showing a gap, whereas with the drywall screws, it was a bit later, but still, this ultimate fail strength isn't really that useful because there's quite a gap already there. The next group is the 3/8 inch dowels, and I used homemade dowels, these ones, and fluted dowel pins that I bought. These are 1.5 inches long. The homemade ones I made a tiny bit longer because I think these ones are just too short. But surprisingly, the dowel pins actually did overall a little bit higher in terms of the ultimate failure. And that's even though the usable length of these is actually a little bit less because they're chamfered on the end. Which is to say the fluting does help a little bit, possibly as much as 20% in the softwood. Next group after that is 5/16 inch dowel pins, which are a little bit smaller than the 3/8, but they did almost as well, so that's pretty good. Then 1/4 inch dowel pins, which are also a bit shorter. These are just 1 1/8 inch long, or about 28 millimeters, and that's actually a pretty good showing considering these dowel pins are so much smaller than the big ones. And then going further down in diameter, I went to 5 millimeter bamboo skewers. Made these a bit longer because these ones are just too short, and these did about as well as the 1/4 inch dowel pins, even though they're thinner, so the length probably helped on those. And impressively, these ones are more than half the strength of a 3/8 inch dowel, even though there's so much less to them. But surface area wise, these have half the surface area as these ones. But before I started filming this video, I did this pull test, and here the skewer itself failed at just 80 kilograms. The grain was crooked. The thing with bamboo is any single piece of bamboo material is likely to have a knot every 30 centimeters or so. So the front edge piece has got a knot here. Another one here. Next one is here. And bamboo skewers are the same, and across their length they typically have one knot. So I just lined up three of them, here, here, and here. If that's part of your dowel pin, that'll really weaken it. Now, I didn't look out for knots at all when I made my test samples, and these two had the lowest fail forces. And with both of these, I can see that the dowel pin itself pulled through the cross grain piece here, which is to say I see no sign of the skewers themselves pulling apart in any of my test samples. So maybe I just got lucky, or maybe this test piece was just unusually bad. Looking at the averages of my fail forces, the 5/16 inch dowel pin actually did surprisingly well compared to the 3/8. Next we have the 1/4 inch dowel pin and the bamboo skewer, which did almost as well as the 1/4 inch dowel pin, but also made my bamboo skewer pins a little bit longer. Worst was the pocket hole, but all the screw joints opened up a fair bit before their ultimate failure. But an interesting takeaway from this is that just a piece of bamboo skewer will hold things together better than a pocket hole screw. Other than the pocket holes, my screw samples relied on screws holding in the end grain. So I screwed some more screws 32 millimeters into blocks of wood, end grain and side grain, and tested that on my strength testing machine to see how well the end grain actually holds. And these tests were all without pilot holes, and for the drywall screws, the end grain held 88% as well as the cross grain. For the number 8 screws, it wasn't quite as consistent, but on average, we got 78% of the holding power in end grain than in cross grain. So surprising, screws in end grain work almost as well as screws in cross grain.